Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the House of Swing, where tonight it is also the House of Monk in every room. Y'all are in for a real treat. I'm going to ask you to welcome our leader for the evening, Mr. Herlin Riley, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. all so very, very much. Thank you all so much. And thank you all for coming out to see us tonight. We know this is New York City. There's Broadway, there's all kind of clubs, and there's a lot of things to do here in New York. But the fact that you came out to check us out, we really, really appreciate your presence. Thank you all so much for being here. Yeah, tonight we're here to celebrate the music of Thelonious Monk, one of our most important figures in jazz music. The impact he had on jazz music, you know, will always be in place, you know, will never go away. He's impacted so many different people from around the world, different ages, different cultures, and, you know, we're here to celebrate that. And tonight we have a nice show prepared for you guys tonight. And we have some, you know, we have three piano players tonight. Mr. Eric Lewis is one of them. He's representing our middle-aged people right now. We also have our youngster, Mr. Isaiah Thompson. He's going to come out a little later on and play for us. And we have our elder statesman, Mr. Ellis Marsalis. He's going to be out here. That's right. So, you know, Monk's music, you know, it captures so many, many different vibrations it spoke to a lot of people. And the thing that really spoke most about Monk's music was his honesty. You know, he just was so honest and pure. And as an artist, that's what we try to do. We try to stay true to our own art and to that inner thing that's inside of us that we can just allow it to come out and without any kind of inhibitions, you know, just to be who you are and let the music, whatever you do, just come out and speak for itself. And Monk embodied that spirit. And tonight we're trying to embody that same spirit. It's just do what we do and let it come out the way that it comes out. And hopefully you guys will like it. Yeah. So right now we're going to feature our tenor saxophonist. As a matter of fact, I want to introduce the brothers to you guys, first of all. This is Mr. Todd Williams on the tenor saxophone. You know, I first met Todd back in 1988. I was a part of the Winston Marsalis quintet at the time. That's before the septet, around the same time that Jazz at Lincoln Center, the whole big band was kind of forming. Todd was in the band already with Winston, and I got to meet him and, you know, share a lot of years on the road and playing music with him. And, you know, he kind of backed away from jazz for a minute. He's an educator now, and he's getting his doctorate in Indiana State. That's right. So, you know, I'm just happy and obliged that he obliged us to come on out again and play some music with us. And welcome to have you, Todd Williams. And also, part of that same band was our bassist tonight, Mr. Reginald Veal. Reginald and I, we've shared the bandstand on many, many different occasions. You know, playing with people in Japan, playing with, you know, the great Ahmad Jamal, great Monte Alexander, you know, so many different people, Diane Reeves and Cassandra Wilson. We played with a lot of different people together. But we started off playing together. I got to tell you all this story. We started off playing with Mr. Ellis Marsalis. And Ellis Marsalis, we were playing at the Jazz Fest in New Orleans. That's right. And he happened to be playing, and Reginald, we were the trio. And Winston happened to be in town that year, and he came and sat in with us. And when he sat in with us, he liked the feel of the rhythm section, you know, of myself and Reginald playing together. And so a couple of years later, he called Reginald to come out and play in the band. And then, you know, finally he called me. Yeah. And so since that marriage, we've shared the bandstand on many, many occasions. And, you know, I always feel very, very comfortable playing with Mr. Veal, because I know whatever we do, he's got my back, and we're going to always make it solid. So I'm just happy to have him on the bandstand with me as well, Mr. Reginald Veal. Yeah, and the young man in the back over there on the vibes, you know, I just met him. This is our first gig together. But I heard him also with Winston's youth orchestra. And, you know, he was just firing up the vibe. I was like, man, who's that little brother? Winston said, that's Joel Ross. So, you know, you're going to hear from Joel Ross later on in the show. But I want to introduce him while he was here, Mr. Joel Ross on the vibe. And what can I say, Mr. Eric Lewis on the piano. Once again, I met this brother also through Winton and through playing with the septet and through the orchestra. And, you know, he always plays with such fire and such command of the instrument. You know, this man, he does things. You'll see, he can do things with the piano that I've never seen anybody else do in the world. You know, he's got 10 fingers and they're all going in different directions. You know, so, you know, once again, Mr. Eric Lewis on the piano. We have some other people that's going to come out later. You know, brother got out of here on this, Mr. Pedrito Martinez. I'll talk about him later on, but he was on the Kungas. So right now, we're going to feature our tenor saxophonist, Mr. Todd Williams. He's going to play a tune that was written by the great Thelonious Monk entitled Epistrophe.
Thank you.
on the tenor saxophone. It's Eric Lewis. Eric Lewis at the piano. Yeah. You know, as I said, Monk's music encompasses so many different people and so many different styles, and also it covers a lot of age groups. So we're going to bring out two young people, and they're going to play. Actually, I want to just introduce you. Miss Melanie Charles. Miss Melanie Charles. Woo! Yes, Miss Melanie Charles. I first heard this young lady about a year ago, and I heard her sing two notes, and I was like, wow, this lady, she's got something inside of her that's very special. And I want to just welcome her and bring her to the bandstand. I understand you used to work here.
She used to work here
as a hostess, huh? She was a hostess, and she had all that talent. You hear it, all this talent just wrapped up in being a hostess, greeting people. But, you know, I wanted to invite her just to be on the stage and, you know, and to share a little bit of her talent with us. And it's also this next young man, his name is Mr. Isaiah Thompson. And come on out, Isaiah. He's a fine pianist. He's our third piano, our pianist for the night. And this young man, I heard him playing with Winston Marsalis' youth orchestra. And, you know, he's a very, very talented brother. So, you know, so Monk's music really touches a wide range of ages and as well as cultures. And, you know, it'll be evident when you hear these two pieces. Ms. Melanie Charles and Mr. Isaiah Thompson. I wanted to say this next piece, actually I forgot, but this next piece is one of Monk's kind of obscure pieces. It's from an album of the same title, and it's one of those kind of quirky pieces, and it's entitled Brilliant Corners.
You dirty rat, you've gone and played the game for so long, you never stopped to think you might be wrong. Sharp as a cat, you clean your whiskers on the side of a cat while your claws are out. Oh, how I love to find the places that I like to go and see you there. Don't care, it's not fair. Maybe I'll go so I won't trump fate. Silly me, I don't understand the many sides you have your chest, like a broken mirror on an armpit stain. Cash in your chips like brilliant corners. Thank you. long you never stop to think you might be wrong. Sharp as a cat, you clean your whiskers on a side of a cat while your claws are out. Oh, how I love to find the places that I love to go and see you there. It's not fair, you don't care. Maybe I'll go so I won't trump fate. Silly me, I don't understand the many sides you have your chest, like a broken mirror on an armpit stain. Cashing your chips like brilliant corners in a good game of chess. Yo bobeat, la bobeo bayonet, second of the yellow bit. Ah bobeat, ya bobeo bayonet, do 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 bit, boo 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 bit.
This is a Thelonious Monk classic. This probably, I would guess, this is probably the most recorded Monk tune. His great Round Midnight. This is Round Midnight, recorded in 1947.
Thank you.
some quarrel we've had needs mending. Doesn't mean that our love is ending. Oh, darling, I need you. Lately, I find you're
Charles. Miss Melanie Charles, I'm so glad you gave up your hostess job. Aren't you glad she gave up the hostess job? Yeah. It's Isaiah Thompson. You know, just a little footnote here. You know, Monk's music encompasses so many different cultures, and it influences so many people from around the world. Melanie is actually from Haiti. She's Haitian, and she sung a chorus in Creole. That was Creole. That was a Creole that she sung the first chorus, and then she came back and she sang, you know, the rest of it in English. But you know, and then, you know, so that's just one aspect of how Monk influenced people from around the world with his music. And this next gentleman I'm going to bring out, he's also from another part of the world. He's from Cuba. He's from Cuba. And oh, he's already here. Yeah, you know, he's a, I mean, this man is incredible on the congas, and I first heard him play about maybe 5 years ago. He was playing at a club on 8th Avenue, and I went in, and my jaw just dropped because this man is so incredible on the congas. And, you know, I was telling him tonight, they were playing some stuff, and, you know, I'm a drummer, and, you know, I can count rhythms, and I can count and know what one is, but they had these people in there, they were from Cuba, and everybody was just kind of doing their thing and dancing, and everybody was dancing. Everybody seemed like they knew what the time was, but me. And you know, I'm just so happy and so grateful that this brother has came in and graced us tonight with his presence and also his talents. And this is Mr. Pedrito Martinez. This is another classic Monk composition. This is entitled Evidence, Evidence.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you all so much. This next tune, I was at the concert last night and I heard Winston Marsalis announce that this is the only tune that Monk ever wrote that had a clave. We kind of turned that last one around. That was a swing tune, but we made it into a kind of Latin tune. But this next tune he actually wrote with a clave rhythm. This is entitled Baya, Baya. Mr. Pedrito Martinez on the Cuban drums. Pedrito Martinez. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. You know, at this time, I'd like to acknowledge, I hope they're still here, the presence of the Monk family. I think they're still here. Hopefully, are you all still here? Someone told me that you were here. Anyway, if you're not here, you're here in spirit, and thank you all, the ones who did show up, thank you all for coming. And, yes. So anyway, this next tune is, we're gonna bring out our elder statesman. And he's a great educator. He's a mentor. He mentored a lot of us, myself and his four sons and Terrence Blanchard and Harry Connick Jr. and, you know, Donald Harrison, and so many others, Reginald Veal. You know, he's a great educator. And a great human being, and a wonderful pianist, and our elder statesman for the evening. I'm speaking of none other than Mr. Ellis Marsalis. Mr. Marsalis.
Thank you.
This is a tune that Monk wrote for his lovely wife, Nellie. And this is entitled Crepuscule, Crepuscule with Nellie, Mr. Ellis Marsalis. Ellis Marsalis. Mr. Ellis Marsalis. Yeah. So this next tune is a tune that Monk wrote for his producer, Mr. Teo Macero. And he calls this simply Teo. Teo.
Yeah.
Mr. Ellis Marsalis. Ellis Marsalis at the piano. Mr. Ellis Marsalis. Reginald Veal on the bass. Once again, Ellis Marsalis. Mr. Ellis Marsalis. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to acknowledge the presence of another great, great man who's had an impact on jazz around the world. And, you know, he's a great pianist, and he actually started all the jazz festivals around the world. And, just, you know, and I feel so honored and so blessed that he's come out to see us tonight. And I'm speaking to none other than Mr. George Ween. Mr. George Ween, right here. Yes, sir. I had the pleasure of sharing the bandstand with Mr. Ween a few times, you know, at the Vanguard, and also we did a cruise ship, and I had a great, great time playing with this man, and I'm so happy and so elated that he came out to see us tonight. Thank you so much for being here. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And as I spoke of earlier, you know, Monk's music really touches a lot of people in a lot of different ways, and also, you know, his music, you know, sometimes people say that his music was so dissonant, but his music was also, you know, very, very simple and like childlike, that you could, children, you know, I play my music, plays his music for children, and they're like, wow, who is that? And it's, you see him dancing, and you see him bopping their heads, and, you know, so, you know, his music really affected a lot of people in a lot of different ways. And, you know, and it also touches the youth, you know, and Monk passed away before these gentlemen were even born. And but his music is so fresh, it's still so fresh, and it's really, really gives us a platform to improvise and, you know, to be expressive. And, you know, so that's very, very important. And so we're gonna play another one of Monk's pieces and feature one of our young musicians tonight on the vibes. You've heard him play a little bit earlier. And we're going to feature him on this next tune. This is a tune entitled Rhythm and Thing. And it's based on the chord changes for George Gershwin's I Got Rhythm. You know, a lot of musicians use both of those, the I Got Rhythm changes and also the blues changes as a platform for improvising. And so we're going to play this one, Rhythm and Thing, and based on the changes from George Gershwin's I Got Rhythm. This is Joe Ross. Joe Ross at the Vibes. Thompson on the piano. Joe Ross, Isaiah Thompson. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, brother. And right now we're gonna bring out our other pianist, Mr. Eric Lewis. We call him ELEW. ELEW, come on, do what you do. Come on out, ELEW, do what you do. Yes, he's gonna play another Monk classic. This is recorded in 1952. This is the classic Trinkle Tinkle, Trinkle Tinkle.
Thank you.
Bush. ELEW, y'all. One and only. Yeah, ELEW. Yes, indeed. Yeah. Wow. That's something else. That man is a monster on the piano. Madman. So we're going to bring back out to the bandstand our youngest piano player, Mr. Isaiah Thompson. Isaiah Thompson. Forgive me, brother. Isaiah Thompson on the piano. This is one Monk wrote while he was with the Blue Note label in 1951. This is entitled Crisscross, Crisscross. Thank you. Thompson, Mr. Isaiah Thompson at the piano. Well, ladies and gentlemen, all good things must come to an end, and so does this set. And we certainly hope you enjoyed our musical offering. On behalf of all my brothers and sisters on the bandstand, we want to thank you all so much for coming out tonight. We're going to close this out. Thank you all so much. And we're going to close this set with the blues, you know, because blues is to jazz like blood is to the body, so we gotta have a little blues. We gotta have a little blues before we close out. And this is the blues by Monk. This is entitled Straight No Chaser. We're gonna bring out everybody. Everybody, this is Straight No Chaser. Yeah. Miss Melanie Charles. Miss Melanie Charles. Mr. Todd Williams. Isaiah Thompson. Reginald Veal. Joe Ross. Pedrito Martinez. Mr. Ellis Marsalis. Mr. Eric Lewis, this is Straight No Chaser.
Because the moment is the place where we love and send it, no one even knows that it's free. Mm-hmm.